Hello and welcome to a video about cracking hydrocarbons. This follows on from the video done on crude oil and the alkanes, and what we're going to look at is how hydrocarbons are cracked to make them more useful. So starting with the idea of or reminder of the fractional distillation tower, we said that we get all these different substances from crude oil that are separated out by the fractionating tower, and we said that the kinds of hydrocarbons that come out near the top of the tower are highly flammable. They have a low viscosity and a low boiling point, and this makes them very useful as fuels. Because of these properties, they have great number of uses as fuels. Now, as you go down the tower, we said that the hydrocarbons near the lower end are much longer chain hydrocarbons, these being very short chain. These are much longer chain hydrocarbons, and they are less useful as fuels, and in fact they have many fewer uses than the hydrocarbons near the top. But what we can do about this is, rather than just accept that we can't use these and either throw them away or just store them away somewhere, we can actually cut them up so they make the shorter chain hydrocarbons. So you can cut them up into shorter chain hydrocarbons, and we call that process cracking. So we're cracking the longer chain hydrocarbons into shorter ones. And the way that happens is, well, one example of how you can do that is to use a set of apparatus that looks like this. So we have a boiling tube that has a what we call a delivery tube. That's just basically a glass tube which delivers whatever's produced in here into this setup over here on the right hand side. This is just water, this is an inverted boiling tube, and the gas that is released from here bubbles up and collects in the top of this boiling tube here. And what we have right here is some ceramic. Ceramic is basically a material like if you broke a teacup, that's the kind of material ceramic is, and it's there as a catalyst. So what that does is it speeds up the reaction that we're about to carry out. Just thought I'd tidy that up there for you. The handwriting was looking a bit untidy. But anyway, we have a ceramic catalyst and we carry out a reaction using this apparatus. And the title of the reaction, or the type of reaction we have, is thermal decomposition. So the reaction is thermal decomposition. That means breaking down using heat. So what we do is we take some wire wool, we dip that in our long chain hydrocarbon, which is in the form of a liquid, and we heat the ceramic catalyst. The ceramic catalyst needs to be nice and hot for this reaction to happen. So we heat over here. We then move the heat over slightly to the wool so that the hydrocarbon can start to evaporate. And this is just the way you move the heat backwards and forwards. We encourage the hydrocarbon, the long chain hydrocarbon, to evaporate. It then passes over the ceramic catalyst. So it evaporates, passes over the ceramic catalyst, and that's where the cracking happens. That's where the long chain hydrocarbon is split into the two different shorter chain hydrocarbons. And one example of a reaction that might happen in here is with something like octane. This is a hydrocarbon that has eight carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbons, and it's a slightly longer chain hydrocarbon. And carrying out this process, what happens is it gets broken into an alkane, and alkanes we've looked at before. In fact, this is a kind of alkane that you might find in a petrol mixture, but it's a shorter chain hydrocarbon, more useful as a fuel. But we also get a substance called an alkene, and we're going to look at that in a bit more detail in a moment. But this alkene, as you can see, is a much shorter chain hydrocarbon. It can be used to burn and produce heat or used as a fuel, but it's also often used to make plastics. And what you might notice about this is that it has a double bond in the middle there, and we're going to have a look at a little bit more detail about alkenes now. So here is an example of an alkene, and this particular example is actually ethene. And things you need to know about alkenes in general is that we describe them as unsaturated, and the reason why we call them unsaturated is because they contain at least one double bond. So you can see this one's got a double bond in there, and so we describe it as unsaturated. And the last thing you need to know and be aware of is the general formula. Now, we looked at the general formula of the alkanes in a previous video. The general formula for the alkenes goes like this: CnH2n. What that means, as a recap, is that whatever number of carbons you have, you just double it to find out the number of hydrogens. So in this example here, we've got two carbons, so instead of N, I put 2. And the number of hydrogens, well, that's just two of our N's, so two of our 2's, that makes 4. So the general formula for ethene is C2H4, and if you look at that, it makes sense, 2 C's, 4 H's. As another example, if we had C3, so 3 carbons, H would be, well, it's 2 3's, so it would be 6. So the formula for this particular alkene, is C3H6. Okay, so that's the features of the alkenes, so a description of how cracking happens, and you should be aware of the process of cracking, some of the keywords that we've gone through, and the features of alkenes.